and how a quick decision changed one man's life. Mike?
Joe and Micah, good evening to both of you. Tonight, we are looking back at that awful day through the eyes of a man who has been asking, what if, for nearly 40 years.
It just takes me back to that time period of what was happening in the world.
In 1979, Chicago Mayor Michael Bolandic had been swept from power after a harsh winter and a botched response to a blizzard.
We still don't know who the victims were.
More than two dozen corpses were pulled from John Wayne Gacy's home. The Iran hostage crisis gripped the country, and so did economic turmoil and a sense of malaise, as President Jimmy Carter put it. As Chicago approached the Memorial Day weekend, a fuel shortage had drivers lining up at gas stations.
I see on the news the gas crisis, I mean, lines just to get gas.
Then 19-year-old Chicagoan James Gilliam was planning a trip to Los Angeles to see his cousin.
You know, I was going to go out and drive up and down the coast a little bit. And then I talked to my cousin a couple of times, and he said, man, you're welcome to come out, but I'm going to tell you what the situation is. I ride my bike to work. He said, so if you are coming out here to kind of hang out, I don't know how it's going to work.
Because of the national gas shortage, just 2 days before he was set to go, he changed his flight.
And I don't know why I chose Atlanta, but I changed my flight arrangements on that Wednesday.
His original ticket was on American Airlines Flight 191.
Bound for Los Angeles.
The doomed aircraft set to depart O'Hare on May 25th, 1979 at 3:04 p.m.
The nose and the left wing apparently hit first.
As the plane took off, the primary engine fell off.
There were multiple explosions.
It was in the air for just 31 seconds before it crashed to the ground, killing all 271 people on board and two people on the ground.
And I said, oh my God, that was my flight.
Gilliam is now 60 years old, a successful banker in Chicago. The course of his life forever changed because of a gas shortage. The lack of fuel kept him going.
Had it not been for the gas crisis, I would have been on that flight. Let me let the families know that we're impacted. You know, my prayers are with them 40 years later, because that easily could have been me. I've never forgotten about that day.